I bought this mandrake pot from Barnes & Noble, and I thought it would be super fun to make a DIY mandrake. So what you will need is tinfoil, clay. The one that I got was air drying clay from Target, and then you'll need a toothpick, string, dirt, and leaves. And then brown paint. So let's get into it. So first, starting off, I'm just going to take some tin foil and make it into a ball. This one, I end up just making a smaller ball and then adding more tin foil to it so it would make the body. And then after I've done that, I moved on to the head, which is obviously going to be smaller. Next, I'm going to take a toothpick and secure the head onto the body. And then following that, I'm going to take two more toothpicks and put arms onto the side of the body. Now moving on to the clay. So I'm going to take a large amount of clay and basically just flatten it out as much as I can so I can wrap it around the body of the mandrake. And then once I end up wrapping it all the way around, if I've missed a few pieces, then I'm going to take extra clay and then just mold it into the rest of the body and smooth it out so it's just one even layer. Taking my hemp string, I'm going to cut a little piece and fray one side of them so I get like a root-like texture. So it basically is just pulling them apart and then twisting the ends. And once I finish doing that to two pieces, I'm going to add it to the ends of the arms just to give them root-like hands so it makes it more like a plant. I am now going to add three different roots to the top just so I can add leaves. From what I saw from the picture, most of them had three roots coming out of the head, so I went with that. And this one, I didn't use any toothpicks, I just molded it into kind of bent shapes that they are on top. For facial features, I started with the eyes and then moved on to doing the nose, mouth, and then back up to the eyes again. And then every time in between, I would take a toothpick and basically mold in each piece so it was not just protruding out of the face. So it was more part of the face instead of just laid on top. So definitely take a toothpick and kind of flatten everything out so it definitely looks more part of the face. Back to the top of the head, I'm just going to add in three leaves, taking it off of fake flowers that I had, cut off the thicker tip at the bottom, and then just stuck them in. Here you can see that it poked through, so I took an extra piece of clay and then just covered it. So back onto the face, I added cheeks and a chin. This I just rolled up little clay balls, added it, and then again, pushing them down into the face with a toothpick just to give a more definition instead of very protruding on the face, where it looks a little bit more real. After doing that, I ended up adding more to the eyes, which was underneath, again, flattening it out with a toothpick. And then I added a little more definition to the body, so I ended up putting an extra layer and then kind of carving into the stomach, if it was like abs or something, I don't know. Just throwing some type of definition in there. And I was going to just carve on top of it, but the clay was so thin that I didn't want it to rip through so you would see the tinfoil, and that's why I ended up just adding the piece of clay on top. So yeah, that is finished for now, and then we are going to now wait for 2 days to let it dry and get into painting. Yay, 2 days later, time to paint. So basically I just mixed a lighter brown with a darker brown and painted on the whole mandrake, top to bottom, in that color. And then once I finished doing that and it ended up drying, I just took the darker brown and just filled in some of the lines that I ended up carving in, or if it just cracked from drying, I just filled those in too. So once I ended up letting it dry, I put it back into the pot and put tin foil piled up under it so it would sit nicer, and then I filled in the dirt around it. And that is it. So I'm super excited about how it came out. I think it's really cute, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and if you guys try it too, definitely comment that down below and tell me your experience. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video.